This is an open letter to the dissidents of my generation. It has been 50 years since we lost Malcolm Shabazz, 20 years since the Battle of Los Angeles, and 5 years since the last gig at CBGB. We are underdogs, often treated like straw dogs, but I am all the more determined for it. I can't help feeling that we, at a time such as this, with our will to resist, are some long-forgotten prophecy fulfilled every step, shaking dust off a dead seer's words, dance. Like the culmination of events that you are, the end of a wait for great things yet to pass. Though we struggle to hold the notes that carry us, to be that will-o'-the-wisp protecting modern mystery, we become well-versed in days of war and nights of love, and found that living this fast, you are never too young to be a storyteller. And we have stories yet to tell, because this is the wake of the American dream, and our choice to open our eyes harsh though the light may be is what separates us. The future holds escalating struggle, as it always has, but now I am not afraid, because the future is in these hands that desperately cling to microphones, cheap guitars and horsehair bows, crossfaders and soldering irons, cigarettes and dandelions, sewing pins and steering wheels, piano keys and megaphones, glass on the lathe, snowballs and stones in the hands of everyone we know. Yeah, the way you hold spray paint, it makes me proud. Tonight, I'll write a favorite line where it won't stay long, but will speak loudly. You will say, repeat after me. I'll write what I want, where I want. I am free. Spice up the melting pot. Don't apologize for being feisty, for baring your teeth to a world that badly needs you. We are reckless, going on wreckage, but trial and error must not be our epitaph, and we do not deserve the tear gas now rolled out like welcome mats. Hold close that idealist heirloom, the maladjusted dream. Do it for the descendants of our fearless descent, for all the survivors who carry our caskets. Though we are told we are too young to dwell on our deaths, they can't see the encroaching great decay. They let their cell phones distract them. The first time a bus ride had the city streets show us their ugly side. After we saw highway underpasses often sport a rough veteran thumb up like an unrun blood-soaked sponge. Our will is a haymaker delivered by Rome's thinker, and our enemies have feared us since we were earth-shaking school children, though now we wring our hands like poor righteous teachers trying to spark consciousness before we find ourselves shouting into the empty expanse of midnight looking for hope. Whilst everyone else sleeps under the coming anticipation of next week's check and tomorrow's hard liquor, the eyes of history turn to us on the cusp of a new century.